Hey everyone, Dave here from Sonic Orb Studios, and it's time for another Your Questions Answered, episode 18. We're going to show you how to take some 4x3 video and turn it and fit it into 16x9. It's not going to scale up, per se. We're going to keep all the information at the top and the bottom, and it's a great trick that you'll see on the news every now and then, so keep your eye out for it. So we have some media here. This is some stock royalty-free footage from videoblocks.com. Great site. I suggest you check them out. We've imported that already, so we won't even have to import that, but you drag and drop it into your project panel here, and we'll just put it into our preview monitor. You can also double-click it, and there we have it. So it's 4x3. We have a 16x9 sort of sequence going on here, and we want to fix that. So let's import this full thing into our timeline. We'll just drag and drop down there. We want to right-click and unlink the audio and video because we want to work with just the video here. We're going to copy that. Quick key is Command or Control V. CNV, and we're going to copy and paste that over. You want to make sure when you paste, have your current time indicator somewhere else, or else it'll just overwrite on the actual original piece. And we're just going to stick that a level above on video track 2. Now, video track 1, we have to do some work on this. And so we are going to first go into our effects control panel, and we're going to scale this up. So something like, I don't know, let's say about 137, something just close. And there's a few things we have to switch up with the other. We're going to add a little bit of crop to the top footage. In fact, let's do that right now. This top one, we have a crop effect here. We can apply that. We're just going to bring this in the left and rights. We're going to bring in a 0.2. And you'll notice if we look at the outer edge of that clear image that's not scaled up, you could see the before and the after. That way, those black lines are gone, and the sky sort of blends in at the top here. So, now we want to work back with video track 1, and we want to add a blur to this. So, we're going to search blur, and we're going to go look for our Gaussian blur, which is down at the bottom list here, and apply that to video track 1, where we can then go to our project effects panel here, and just turn up the blurriness. We don't want to go crazy on it. Add some detail loss, but not crazy amounts. And there we have it. And we're going to repeat the pixel edges for a little bit of smoothness to it. So now if we play this back, you'll notice it's sort of interactive. It's not static looking. It's not cruddy looking in any way, shape, or form. It sort of just flows together, especially this right side with the motion. And that's what you really want to look for. And I think that's what we've achieved here. So that is how you quickly and easily turn 4x3 media into a 16x9 composition or sequence, if you will, in Adobe Premiere Pro CS5 right here today. Thanks, guys, for watching. Feel free to comment, rate, subscribe. I'm Dave from Sonic Orb Studios. Check out my website, sonicorbstudios.com. And if you have any questions or concerns or anything about software or products that you see me review here at this channel, feel free to send me a message, and I'll get right back to you as soon as I can. Thanks, guys, for watching. See you next time.